introduce yourselves. You guys work on Gigapan.
We do.
You want to give us a little background on what that site is and kind of what it does?
Sure, sure. Well, I'm Rich Gibson.
I'm Gabriel O'Donnell.
And we both work on the Gigapan project. The Gigapan project was originally a product of CMU and NASA Ames. Going back in time, it originally came about where we needed to stitch, Randy Sargent needed to stitch the images that came from the Mars exploration rover, Spirit and Opportunity. And it gave us an opportunity to see and care about Mars in a way we never had before. So Randy had this idea, if we care about Mars because we can explore images of it, what if we brought that technology back to the Earth so we could care about the Earth? So it became part of the Global Connections project. And now we have a robot imager that can take lots of pictures, stitching software to stitch them together, and a website where people can upload, share, explore, annotate amazing, brilliant gigapixel imagery.
That's great. That sounds great. And you've got actually some fairly famous panoramas up there now.
We do. We do. The most famous is of the Obama inauguration. 30 million people have seen it.
Something like that. Man.
Yeah.
Probably more traffic than we ever expected to get. Within the first 2 weeks of that pano going viral, more people had seen that Gigapan than every other single Gigapan on our site combined.
Yeah, it's kind of amazing. And it was his first Gigapan. After he took it, he stitched it, he called, he said, where do I return this unit? Because it's interesting, but I don't think I'll use it in my regular photography. I think he's since changed his mind.
So you guys are actually also a user of App Engine.
Yes.
That's right.
So how did that come about?
So basically what we realized was when the Obama pano went viral, our kind of simple lamp setup, it wasn't sufficient. That we were consuming way too much of the pipeline at CMU, and B, we really realized that we had a distributed distributed file system, and it wasn't implemented, I think, the way we wanted to implement it. We didn't have full confidence in the ideas of backup and like ease of access and things like that. So I actually don't know who initiated it, if it was you reaching out or we reached out to you, but the end result was that we started using App Engine as our tile storage host. We moved the Obama panos over, and it was really spectacular. We went from taking up, and this was at the point where traffic had already decreased, but it was still a lot. We went from, taking up 200 megabits a second of CMU's pipe to, 0 megabits per second, because it was all going to App Engine, which led to the funny thing, I think, where it was maybe even unexpected for you guys, maybe the amount of traffic, because I remember you guys saying, okay, well, turn the switch. And we turned the switch, and then 2 hours later, it was like, whoa!
Yep, So App Engine held up?
It held up tremendously, yeah. As a developer, one of the kind of, and this is on the fringes of the scenes, one of the kind of worries we had was, you hear rumors about latency, and maybe they're exaggerated, maybe they weren't initially. We've had no problems whatsoever. And the thing that's neat with the tile fetches for a panorama is that you would notice, and you would notice pretty quickly because you'd have big empty black spaces in your panorama, and we don't see those.
Excellent. So you moved over. Did you experience any sort of challenges moving over to using the App Engine?
I think we're still in the process, actually, of really optimizing and figuring out exactly whether or not we've made the correct optimizations. One of the kind of hard challenges is we went from a system where we could really rely on lexical locality because we were serving from a file system to App Engine, where that's not really, it's a different model to kind of get your head around. And so I think it might be what happens if you are a serial programmer and you're beginning to write parallel code. I suspect it's actually like a similar transition.
Okay, great. So, and you guys were you're using the Python version of App Engine?
That's correct, yeah.
Okay, and you were previously Python shop?
Yes.
Okay, great. What are the other aspects, how has the App Engine impacted how you've developed and anything like that? You've been working with it long enough that it's actually kind of changed your development style?
It's actually, previously what we had, there was two main developers. David Holstius is probably the project lead in general. The site was originally written in PHP, and we started moving to Django, which is a Python-based web ORM. And now that we're moving to App Engine, so one of the things that's been really nice about App Engine is the ability to actually download the environment right on your desktop. Previously, what we were doing was we would each have our own kind of shared SVN repo, and check it out into separate little websites. Which, when it's just two developers, it's okay because you can communicate. As we've been adding developers to the group, we've noticed problems creeping in. And the actual ability then to like kind of pull down the app, work on it locally, like with our own set of things, and then check it back in using Git. We're actually using Git locally, but checking it back up, when we push the changes back up to App Engine, it's been a lot easier.
Right. Yeah. So if you had any advice to give to somebody who's just coming to App Engine, what would be like the one piece of advice you'd want to hand over to them?
I would look very strongly into maybe object optimizations, that how you need to rewrite your objects. Chances are, if you're coming from a LAMP development environment, you've gotten really good at optimizing for SQL. And that's no longer an issue. And you've got new tricks and new tools that you have to learn to use, and you have to learn to use them well. So that's probably where I would recommend developers spend the most time, like leading into it, especially if they're porting a legacy site to App Engine.
All right, that's great. Well, thanks, guys.
Thanks, Joe.
Good having you here.
Thank you.